bookstore, and the name of the bookstore is called The Grimoire. Some people may not know what that is. And in fact, one of the reasons that I didn't publish with another publisher is because the editor there said, I don't know what a grimoire is. And I thought, that's not boding well for the rest of this book, really. So a grimoire is a book of spells and incantations. And it is the name of this bookstore, which is a magical place. It is the repository of all the stories in the world and expands as more stories come in and contracts as more stories go out. But nobody notices this because magic, you know. And if you aren't meant to find this bookstore, you never shall. So the bookstore is very much a character in the book. And here's the fun part, wait for it. Both my brothers committed suicide. Nothing, it's funny, I told that and nobody ever laughs, I don't understand why, but I started trying to write about the death by suicide of my brothers as a memoir many years ago, and that I wasn't gonna survive the writing of that. And so I tried to write it as realistic fiction, and you know, that's just as depressing as writing a memoir, it turns out. So I put it aside for a while, and as I often do when I can't figure out what the hell I'm doing, I go to the store of folk tales and fairy tales that I have, and I reread The Snow Queen. Does everybody know that? That story by Hans Christian Andersen, and you know, forgive me, Hans, but it's the worst ending in all the fairy tales. It ends up with this sort of ode to Jesus and the Lord's Prayer. It's very odd and very unfairy tale-like, so that doesn't happen, in case anybody's worried. The Snow Queen has this great idea in it, that there's this mirror that makes everything that's beautiful ugly look ugly, and everything that's ugly look beautiful. And then it smashes and it goes out into the world, and there are little specks that get into people's eyes and then into their hearts, and it changes them. And I thought, well, if that's not a great metaphor for addiction, which is really what killed my brothers, I don't know what is. Because we always say that addiction is a disease of perception. Right? You just don't see things the way they are when you're high or hammered. And I happen to know this fairly well myself, but that's a long and old story. So I started thinking about how I could use that fairy tale for this story. And what I loved about it was, given the structure of the fairy tale and the, you know, the sort of seven episodes and all the things that happen in fairy tales, it made me feel safe so that I could write about this strange world of addiction and this bookstore and this drug that takes you into another world. And Maggie, the protagonist, is the only person we know of who has managed to get away from this drug. And she washes up in the back door of this store, the Grimoire, and is taken in. And there sort of barricades herself, as you see, until she begins getting notes from her brother saying, follow me. I need you, because he has now fallen under the sway of this drug, and she has to decide whether or not she's going to go rescue him, or at least try to. And of course, if she'd said no, well, the book's over, it would have been very short, so we know she says yes, right? And when she goes into this other world, it becomes a place where, well, caribous fly, for one thing, so there's that. But the road sort of rolls up behind you. Space does not work the way it does here, and all of that is beginning to, how do I say it, to leak over into the normal world. And so this also, for me, feels like the opioid crisis and what's happening, where neighborhoods are changed and families are changed, and you know, time seems to contract and space seems to contract. But as we were talking to a couple of bookstore owners today, I realized that all of that's really interesting, I hope. But what is really interesting about the book is there's a dog in it, and the dog doesn't die. And somebody called me for an interview a while back, and they said, oh, thank God you didn't kill the dog. What is it about Canadian authors? They always kill the dog. So there is a dog. The dog does not die. And I will tell you that in any of my books, if there is a dog, you can be guaranteed the dog will not die. So, yes, you're most welcome. It's terrible. So I'm just going to read a little bit from the